Okay guys, I wanted to talk to you a little bit about my encaustic wax setup before we begin the project. So we're going to be using wax as our final layer on our project, and if you've never used this before, this is encaustic medium. It's made by a company called R&F, and you melt these little beads, little bead granule thingies, on a hot plate. And there's a lot of different ways you can set this up, but this is what works for me. I just have a little mini griddle that I got from a local store, very inexpensive. I have one of these disposable little tins that you can get from the grocery store, and I put my medium right into one of these so that I can move it around and it doesn't make a huge mess. I do have quite a bit of wax actually on the griddle. I can easily clean that up, but that's kind of where how I leave it, because I don't do a lot of mixing of color on this hot palette. If I did that, I would have little tins, and I would mix the color in those tins. But since we're just using the clear encaustic medium as our finishing touch on our piece, I don't have all the rest of the colored waxes and things that you can use. So when you set this up in your house, you want to be near a window or some kind of ventilation. Although if you keep the wax at around 200 degrees, which is kind of exactly where you want it, it shouldn't smoke and it shouldn't produce a lot of toxins or a bad smell. You'll smell it. It smells kind of like melted wax, which makes sense. But make sure you keep it around 180 to 200. This little guy, because it's an inexpensive little thing, I've noticed that when I put it up to 200, my little thermometer tells me that it's going higher than 200, so I keep it just under 200, and then I always double check on my thermometer here. And you can get one of these really inexpensively too at any grocery store, and I highly recommend it because the little temperature gauge on these griddles are not super accurate. This way you can see exactly what temperature your wax is at. This brush is actually kind of stuck on here. Here we go. So because it's got wax all over it. So everything is cold right now, obviously. When it turns on and the wax finally melts, it becomes a kind of clear gold, and you'll see that in the video. And I just wanted to kind of explain the setup. So you need a griddle. You need something to put your medium in. You need your medium, and I'll have links and the supply list for everything on in the class. And then these brushes, you want to make sure, these are Hake brushes that I ordered from Amazon, and they're made by a company called Lang Nickel. You want to make sure when you're doing encaustic work that you always use brushes with natural hair, okay? If you get a nylon brush or something and you put it right here and let it hang out with the wax, it will melt and then you'll have a big old mess. So you want to make sure you're using natural fibered brushes. So they don't have to be the Hake brush, although I find these are really wonderful and deliver the wax really well onto the board. But just make sure it's natural. Okay, no artificial brushes with the wax. When you do your fusing, you're gonna see me using this little craft dryer. You can use a lot of different things to fuse wax. Some people use a blowtorch. Some people use a heat gun. This little guy is fine for a small project. It's a little slower than a heat gun or a blowtorch, obviously, but it works fine, and a lot of people have these. They're inexpensive, and a lot of us have them as mixed media artists. So you're gonna need this to do your fusing. And you'll see me do that in the project video. But I just wanted to explain the setup. The other thing that you want to have around is some wax paper. When this wax gets on any other surface, it cools, it's kind of hard to get off. So it's hard to get off your table, much harder than, let's say, candle wax. Because it has, so this is actually a blend of beeswax and damar resin. Damar resin is something that comes from a tree, and it actually creates a clearer, harder surface than just using beeswax alone. And so that's why I like to use the encaustic medium on top of my paintings. You can certainly use beeswax as well, but just realize it's going to be cloudier. And if it's unfiltered beeswax, it's going to have more of a yellow cast. So I've had the best luck using the encaustic medium. So that's kind of my setup for wax. So I'll have a supply list listed in the class so that you guys know exactly what you need to get. And if you have any questions, let me know. Okay, now I think we're ready. Obviously, we're using heat. Let me just mention, be careful, be safe, Don't have flammable things around your workspace. And again, make sure you have some ventilation, because some people are more sensitive to the wax than others, and you definitely want some fresh air coming in. This is a very small setup, so don't feel like you need exhaust fans and, you know, get crazy, but I usually just have a couple windows open when I'm using the wax. All right, so let's move on to the video. Guys, I also wanted to mention cleanup. As you can see, I'm not super particular. This is obviously, this griddle's only used for my encaustic work, so I'm not gonna be, you know, making pancakes on this Saturday morning. So you wanna have some designated things for encaustics. You wanna have brushes you only use for encaustics, because even if I clean this with soy wax, which is what you can do to clean your brushes, it's not gonna be good for painting. So keep things dedicated to the encaustics. If you want to clean off your surface here, you can, when it's molten and hot, you can wipe it down with old rags or paper towels and just throw the paper towels away. You can buy soy wax to clean your brushes and to clean the surface of this. I haven't done that. If you want to be more particular about it, you can. I'll have a link in the class about cleanup for encaustics, but I kind of just keep it the way it is. Like I said, I'm not using a lot of different colors and things at this point, so it's kind of all the same stuff, and my brush, it doesn't hurt the brush to keep the wax in it, because you just, when you're ready to go, you just lay the brush on the hot plate and it'll get soft and all the wax will come out of it. So that's kind of how I do it, and yeah, see what works for you. All right, thanks.